The male reproductive system is under the control of two hormones, FSH and LH, which are secreted from the pituitary region at the base of the brain. The male reproductive system contains two oval-shaped testis tissue, where sperm, the male reproductive cell, is produced. The blood vessels that carry the sperm from the testicles to the urethra are called vas deferens. The urethra is the canal in the penis where urine and sperm are transported. With sexual ejaculation in men, the vas deferens push the sperm towards the glands called the prostate and seminal vesicles. These glands produce a secretion that forms the semen, in which the sperm is transported. When this secretion and sperm unite, residual semen is formed and is advanced in the urethra and is emptied into the vagina in the female genital tract with ejaculation. The male reproductive cell is called sperm. Pioneer sperm cells migrate from the genital fold, which is the production site in the abdominal cavity, to the testicles male ovary, which is the main place when the baby boy is in his first month in the mother's womb. And it stays here in silence for 12 to 13 years until puberty. With the onset of puberty, these cells begin to multiply throughout life. And after some genetic divisions, the number of chromosomes is halved and sperm cells are formed. The purpose of this half is to reach the full set of chromosomes after fusion, with the female egg cell, and to form an embryo of half mother and half father origin. While this halving is done as needed in the male, it started in the womb and was paused in a phase in the female baby. The male cell with this half chromosome then acquires a very special structure in order to fertilize the egg. It has a tail that enables movement, is very fast, and has a cylindrical structure with half a set of chromosomes. There is a cell membrane around the head, just below it. Enzymes that will dissolve the outer shell of the egg are stored, and the nucleus carrying the chromosome is located in the head. It has a tail that enables movement, is very fast, and has a cylindrical structure with half a set of chromosomes. There is a cell membrane around the head, just below it. Enzymes that will dissolve the outer shell of the egg are stored, and the nucleus carrying the chromosome is located in the head. The neck is followed by the tail, which will provide the long journey to the egg. The sperm cell also carries the X or Y chromosome, which will determine the sex of the baby to be formed. During sexual intercourse, a large number of sperm cells in the liquid discharged into the vagina have to overcome a very difficult tract with many obstacles in order to reach the egg that is waiting for it in the tubes. The mucus secretion in the cervix contains a chemical structure that changes according to the menstrual cycle with hormonal effect. While this chemical structure facilitates the passage of sperm during the ovulation period, it creates an almost impenetrable barrier for the sperm at other times. Once it reaches the uterus, uterine contractions only allow some sperm to reach the upper tubes. In the narrowest part of the tubes, the sperm adhere to the inner layer of the tubes, and this layer melts the membrane at the head of the sperm, making it ready for fertilization, and the sperm gains even more speed. This process is very important for a successful fertilization and takes 6 to 8 hours. The mature sperm, which has completed its preparation for fertilization, continues its journey along the tube. The sperm, which is advanced in the form of contraction in the tube and floating over the hairs covering the inner surface of the tubes, reaches the widest region where the egg awaits, and fertilization will take place. An average of 400 sperm manage to reach the egg waiting in the tubes, and only one of them will be able to pass through the thick outer shell. Don't forget to like the channel and subscribe.